Good morning and welcome to the e-class of St. Xavier's High School, Agra. Today, we are going to study science of standard 8, chapter number 2, that is microorganisms, friend and foe. So children, we have studied about what are the microorganisms, how they are useful and how they can be more dangerous to us and they can cause various kinds of threatening diseases, okay, threatening diseases as well as very normal diseases. So let us see some objectives as well as question answers of exercise. Fill in the blanks. A. Microorganisms can be seen with the help of a dash microscope. Blue, green, algae. Fix dash directly from air. Enhance fertility of soil. Fix nitrogen. C. Alcohol is produced with the help of yeast. D. Cholera is caused by the dash bacteria. Now second question, pick the correct answer. A. Yeast is used in the production of alcohol is the answer. B. The following is an antibiotic, that is streptomycin. Then C. Carrier of malaria causing protozoan is female anopheles mosquito. The D question, the most common carrier of communicable disease is housefly. The option is housefly. The next MCQ, the bread or idli dough rises because of, option is third answer, growth of yeast cells. F question, the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is called fermentation. Now children, third question, that is match the following column A and B. So children, I have directly written the answer. You all write it in your notebook. First, bacteria answer is causing cholera, that is E option. Rhizobium, that is option A, fixing nitrogen. Then lactobacillus. Lactobacillus is for settling of curd. So option is D, yeast. Yeast is for baking of bread. Okay, for commercial use also it is used. Now, a protozoan, option D is causing malaria. Sixth, a virus that causing AIDS. That is option F. Now, the next question. Can microorganisms be seen with the help of the naked eye? If not, how can they be seen? Answer. Microorganisms are extremely tiny living beings which are not seen by our naked eyes. To observe these microorganisms, we need to use microscope. The next question, that is? Fifth question. What are the major groups of microorganisms? Microorganisms are classified into five major groups. These are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, some algae and viruses. So children, you have to write it in the point wise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay children? Always write in the way which I have showed you in the PDF. Points wise I have an answer, so you point wise the answer likhna hai. Then, sixth question. Name the microorganisms which can fix atmospheric nitrogen in the soil. So children, we have to write the name of the microorganisms which fix the nitrogen which is present in the atmosphere into the soil. So let's see the answer. First point, bacteria like rhizobia is involved in the fixation of nitrogen in leguminous plants. Second, nitrogen is one of the essential constituents of all living organisms as part of proteins, chlorophyll, nucleic acids and vitamins. Then, third point, the atmospheric nitrogen cannot be taken directly by plants and animals. Certain bacteria and blue green algae present in the soil fix nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert it into the compounds of hydrogen. So children, how this will be happening? This will happen by the rhizobium bacteria. What does rhizobium bacteria do? Rhizobium bacteria take the nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert it into the soil nitrogen so that the plants can absorb these nitrogen very nicely. Then, next question, that is seventh question. Write 10 lines on the usefulness of microorganisms in our lives. So children, we have to write about the 10 useful points about the microorganisms. So point wise answer, let us see. Uses of microorganisms are listed below. They are helpful in cleaning up the environment. For example, organic waste, vegetable peels, remains of animals, feces, etc. are broken down into harmless and unstable substances by bacteria. By usable substances like bacteria. Curd contains several microorganisms. Of these, the bacteria lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd and it multiplies in milk and converts into the curd. So curd kaise banega? By inoculating sirf itna amount hame kya karna hai, curd is milk in the whole milk, then it will get converted into curd by the help of the lactobacillus bacteria. Next, bacteria also involved in making of cheese, pickles and many other food items. Next point, bacteria and yeast are also helpful for fermentation of rice, idlis and dosa batters. Next, yeast reproduce rapidly and produces carbon dioxide during respiration. Bubbles of the gas fill the dough and increase its volume. This is the basis of the use of yeast in the baking industry. In the baking industry for making bread, pastries and cake. Next point. Microorganisms are used for the large-scale production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid, that is vinegar. Then, antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. Next point. Microorganisms are helpful in producing vaccines against diseases-causing agents. Then, some bacteria are able to fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to enrich with nitrogen and increase its fertility. Then, microorganisms decompose dead organic waste of plants and animals to convert them into simple substances. These substances are again used by other plants and animals. Thus, microorganisms can be used to degrade the harmful and smelly substances and thereby they clean the environment. So children, in this way, okay, the microorganisms are so much helpful for in our daily life as an economic purpose also and in our daily life also. Now, our next question. Write a short note or a paragraph on the harmful effects of microorganisms. So children, abhi humne uske useful points dekhe, now we will be studying about the harmful effects. Microorganisms are harmful and can cause diseases in human beings, plants and animals. Diseases caused by bacteria are cholera, tuberculosis and typhoid. Third, anthrax is a dangerous human and cattle disease caused by a bacterium. Okay, ye disease hai, uska naam anthrax hai, which is very dangerous for human as well as cattle. Okay, foot and mouth disease of cattle is also caused by a virus. Now, in plants, productivity of wheat, rice, potato, sugarcane, orange, apple and others can all be reduced by the microorganisms. So, ye jo productivity hai, wheat, rice, potato aur bahut sare other crops ki, that production can be decreased by the cause of the microorganisms. Microbes also spoil our food and other materials. Hamara khana bigad jata hai, if we keep it outside, okay, then what will happen? It will get spoiled. Some smell is coming due to these microbes which attack that food. Now, the last question of your chapter, okay, of your exercise. What are antibiotics? What precautions must be microorganisms. The these medicines kill or stop the growth of disease causing microorganisms. Such medicines are called antibiotics. So children, if it asks a 1 mark question, तो आपको क्या लेना है? ये सिर्फ इतना ही लेना है. And if it is asked for 3 to 4 marks, then you have to write this whole answer. Now, what precautions we have to take? Let's see. Precautions must be taken while taking antibiotics are as follows. Antibiotics must be taken only on the advice of a qualified doctor. हमें we should consult a doctor, then and then only we should have antibiotics, or else we should not have those antibiotics. Any antibiotic. The course of antibiotics should be completed as prescribed by the doctor. Jitna course bola hai, 5 days ka bola hai, 10 days ka bola hai, everything we should be very prescribed. Whatever the doctor has prescribed us, in that room only we should have these antibiotics. If you take antibiotics when not needed or in wrong doses, it may take the drug less effective when you might need it in future. So children, अगर हम अननेसेसरली दिस एंटीबायोटिक्स ले लेंगे, देन व्हाट विल हैपन? इट विल नॉट गेट अफेक्ट. उसका कोई अफेक्ट नहीं होगा, हमारे इफेक्ट नहीं होगा व्हेन वी विल बी यूजिंग फॉर अवर दैट पर्पस. ओके, सो अननेसेसरी आल्सो वी शुड नॉट हैव दस एंटीबायोटिक्स. सो चिल्ड्रन, इधर द आएगा, ओके, नॉट ही, इधर टी आ जाएगा. ओके, the course of antibiotics. So this was all about the chapter number 2 exercise. So I hope you all have understood about this chapter as well as this whole exercise. All the question answers you have to write it in your notebook, as well as all the objectives also you have to write in your notebook. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.